You say what?
I said, I dreamt of you, but I don't know you.
Huh?
I dreamt of you, but I don't know you, and this is my first time.
How did you dream about me?
It's like I was praying. I'm a pastor myself. I have a ministry that I'm leading.
Pastor, you're welcome. So you have a ministry?
Yes.
And you dream about me?
Yes.
How it is that?
I always dream about Prophet Senior TB Jeshua. And then I am praying inside that, how can I connect myself to him? But as I was praying, then I saw a vision of you coming into me.
And you never know me.
I don't know you.
So you have been praying that, how can you be connected to Prophet TB Joshua?
Yes.
And how did you see me?
I saw you in a vision and you said, yes, I was seeing you also, you were roaming around. But you were failing to connect yourself. But you have done a good luck to come to me.
So now, how did you come here now?
Now, I was connected by my colleagues. He says, if you are looking for that man, then I can give you direction.
How did you know about me? How did you talk that man about me? How did you know about me? And how that person know about me?
That person.
How did you know that I was here in Cape Town?
I always hear about you by people.
But you never
but
see me.
But I said, no, I can't just go for every man of God unless and until God speaks to me.
And when you fast and you pray, you see me?
I fasted for 2 months.
Huh?
2 months.
Then you come and see me?
Yes, then I saw you and I said, now I can go to this man.
Where is your ministry? Where is your ministry?
It's in Gugulethu.
In Gugulethu.
Yes. Mm. And I was busy praying about the ministry because the ministry is not stable. Then in the vision, you told me that your ministry is going to grow now.
Mm. If God says something, who are we to stop it? Yes. TB Joshua is a servant of God. I am a servant of God. But one thing I know, there's a kingdom where we belong. Are you with me? That's the kingdom I'm talking now, the kingdom of God. Me too, I force myself, by force, I must go and see that man. I just need a touch from that man for things to start changing. Are you with me?
Yes, man of God.
Let the will of God be done according to what God have prepared for you. Mm? I'll be happy one day I come and visit you in Gugulethu. Come on, the name of Jesus Christ. Father, there's anointing that brings people from nowhere. That anointing attracts, it's got the smell of yourself, Jesus Christ. And where there's a light, people can see it. The light is not under the table. But the light must be in a mountain now in Gugulethu. And people must see that light like a star of Jesus in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you. God bless 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 you. Wow. God bless you. Time by time visit us.
Thank you, man.
One day we'll visit you in Gugulethu.
Amen. I receive.
You're welcome.
I receive.
God bless you.
Amen.
The only thing, you don't pray for 2 months. It's too much. Are you with me?
Amen.
You don't pray for 2 months. It's too much. Learn to pray in a room. You have a room?
Yes, I do.
Enter in the room.
Yes.
And talk to the Father.
Amen, man of God.
The same way Jesus said, enter in the room, close it.
Amen, man of God.
And go on your knee and pray.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Amen.
It's more than doing 2 months.
Amen, man of God. I receive.
I don't know if you understand me.
I receive.
Entering in the room, close the door, and you talk to the Father.
Amen.
It's one of the first steps you can start with it.
Amen, man
of God. A culture.
Yes, man of God.
of creating entering in the room. Amen. Because that's what he said. He never said pray for 2 months. You have a Bible?
Yes, man.
Have you seen anywhere they say pray for 2 months?
No.
There's no place.
Yes.
You know, we must not do what God never tell us. But let us follow the room.
Go.
Oh, please let me talk, my brother. The kingdom of God must be extended. I'm revealing a secret. The kingdom of God must be revealed. Amen. The kingdom of God must be extended. Are you with me? The kingdom of God must be bigger. I have a brother sent from heaven. The light must be go higher and higher in the Gugulethu. Say Gugulethu!
Gugulethu!
Enter in the room. Close the door. Are you with me? Don't let the door open. Close it.
Yes.
The door must be bar.
Yes, man.
When
of
you
God.
Close it, you go on the knee.
Yes, man of God.
You use Psalm 51.
Yes, man of God.
I say, Father, forgive me.
Yes, man of
Love
God.
Love faith in the bowsh. Come on, the name of Jesus Christ.
Can you tell us your name, your age, and where you come from?
My name is Shane Nyama. I come from Gugulethu and I'm 35 years now.
Is it your first time to come in this ministry?
Yes, it's my first time.
What are your experience during the service and what can you say?
The word was powerful. I learned a lot, and the moment I get on the prayer line, when the man of God touched me, I feel a movement from my head to the toes, like I'm freezing my body, and I could feel that this is the movement of the power of the Holy Ghost within my body.
Within your body. That was during the service or during the deliverance?
During the deliverance time.
Okay. So how did you come to know about this ministry before?
I always hear by people talking about Apostle Stephen.
Talking about what? Can
just
you elaborate it?
Talking about Apostle Stephen is a man of God, he's a son of Prophet T.B. Joshua, and I just said, I know it's fine, then why should I bother myself by going to see him, yet I'm also a man of God.
So what did you come and seek here?
The thing is now, as I was in my prayer and fastings, I was wishing to pray to God such that he can open a door for me to reach Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. But as I was praying now, God showed me Apostle Stephen in a vision, and he says, you better go and see this man than wasting your time going there, yet you are not at that level to reach at that time at that man.
That was in a vision?
Yes.
During your prayer and fasting?
Yes.
For how many
for
days?
For 2 months.
For 2 months.
Yes.
So you were seeking spiritual direction.
Exactly.
And then you see God telling you, directing you to Apostle Stephen.
Exactly.
Can you continue?
Yes, as he showed me Apostle Stephen, there is only one thing that shocked me in that vision, because I started seeing sons of Prophet T.B. Joshua, but for him he was said to be, he was above all. In fact, I can say I was seeing in a form of angels, in a form of angels, and the Lord was saying, this man is like an ancient angels in the realm of the spirit.
Oh.
Apostle Stephen.
Okay, during the vision?
Yes.
Okay, continue.
And then in that dream, he says, I accept you to be my son. Then I celebrated like never before. And even when morning comes, I said, on a Sunday, I'm not going to attend any service, to lead any service on my ministry. I better go to Apostle Stephen and see him. That's when I started contacting some other people to give me some direction to come here.
And then when you came here, you confirmed that vision was true.
Yes, that vision was true, because at first time in a vision, I saw him, he touched me, and he went at first, and he came back again. And when I came here, it happened exactly, because he touched me and he prayed for me for the first time, and he came back for me for the second time again.
So you mentioned earlier on that you are a pastor.
Yes, I'm a pastor.
And what are the name of your ministry?
It's Royal Kingdom Embers.
And where is it located?
In Gugulethu.
In Gugulethu.
Yes.
Can you elaborate more about your experiences during prayer line, when the man of God, Apostle Stephen, was praying to you on prayer line?
When he was praying to me, it's like I was waiting to see which exactly is his gift going, you know. So the moment he touched me, I could not feel myself at that moment. And I said, the moment he can do like this, he can wave his hand, I saw myself just going that same side. When he do like this, I saw myself going the same direction. And in my senses, I said, now I'm under the control of the power of the Holy Ghost.
So you mean you couldn't understand yourself?
Yes.
The power was too much.
The power was too much.
Have you seen this one before?
I never experienced it before.
You mean in all Cape Town you never seen it?
I never seen it.
So is your first time to fall?
Yeah, this is my first time to fall.
You never fell before?
I never fell before.
And then you are a pastor as well with the congregation?
Yes, I'm a pastor.
Glory be to God. Can you continue elaborating?
My church is like, I started just last year, this branch. Then it goes like I can reach the number of 50. Then suddenly it starts to drop. So suddenly it starts to drop. People start to move out. People start to fight within the ministries. And I was saying, why God, you sent me to do your work, but the things are like this, you see. So that's when I came to say, I must look for a spiritual father. But the one person who was in my heart is Prophet T.B. Joshua, not knowing that I can find another man of God who is closer.
So you mean you started last year? So which means is the year which you received the calling from God?
I received a calling from God long time back, but I was just waiting.
And then you decided to start last year?
Yes.
And then later on, you decided to seek spiritual direction?
Yeah, exactly, because all along I hadn't had any spiritual direction. I was just doing it.
And God directed you here to Apostle Stephen?
Yes.
Did you receive what you were looking for?
I really received what I'm looking for.
Are you sure? Can you mean it?
I did pay anything.
You never pay anything?
I never pay anything.
So you receive it for free?
Yes, because that's what the Bible says. The Bible says, I gave you freely and you must give freely. So that's the other way we can see that this man is a real man of God.
So you mentioned that you heard about this church from people were talking about Apostle Stephen.
Yes.
What they were talking, and now you saw him.
Yeah, now I really confirm.
What can you say about what they were talking and the real experience?
Yeah, what I always heard and what I have seen now, I see that this man is surely used by God. If you are seeking for something that comes from God, you are on a right place and at a right time in this ministry.
Wow, that is true. So what can you say to others, fellow pastors, believers in Christ Jesus?
Yeah, I can say God always uses people. There are some people who says, I pray inside my door and whatsoever. But as we know that God uses people, it's good to have a servant of God who can give you the spiritual direction in your life. And if you come in this ministry, you will surely have a testimony.
Wow, Pastor, we are rejoicing with you. We have seen that you have received an impartation.
Amen.
And then, are you sure there is something changed in you or what?
I have already believed, especially in my dream. So this was just a confirmation.
It's a confirmation of what you received through dream.
Yes.
Glory be to God. So we want to encourage you, as you have received that impartation through Christ Jesus, you can only maintain it with him by the help of the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit to make you maintain what you have received through him, so that your ministry can grow from glory to glory, from power to power. Always be humble and listen to the direction of the Holy Spirit. Pastor, you have any word of encourage or any advising word to the people which are listening to you?
What I can say is, I can say, people of God, let's continue worshiping the Lord, and we are at the right place at the right time. May the glory of the Lord be upon our lives and take us to another dimension. I say amen to everything that the Lord has done to me.
Thank you so much, Pastor. Remember, better is not good enough. the best is yet to come. We are waiting to see your big testimony after receiving a great impartation in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. I glorify the Lord. Amen.